So far, we have talked about two important terms related to acceptance sampling, which are AQL and RQL. There is another important term, which is average outgoing quality. Let's talk about this now. Let's look at the definition first, which says that for a particular process average, the AOQ or the average outgoing quality is the average quality of outgoing product, including all accepted lot or batches plus all rejected lots or batches after the rejected lot or batches have been effectively 100% inspected and all defectives replaced by non-defectives. Let's take a scenario where you are getting lots one by one. So you get a first lot based on the sampling. You accepted that lot that goes into your work. Now second lot comes and then you reject that lot. Now what happens to this rejected lot? This rejected lot will go through screening. So each of these pieces will be checked. Good pieces will be kept on one side. Bad pieces will be kept on another side. And then bad pieces will be replaced by good pieces. Let's say you received 1000 items. In that you found out that there are 50 defectives. You remove those 50 defectives and put 50 new pieces in that. And now you have a batch which has 1000 pieces and all these pieces are good. And this was the batch which was originally rejected because of high percentage defectives. So this is what will happen. Acceptable lot will go to the factory. Rejectable lot will go through screening and all those defective pieces will be replaced with the good pieces and that good lot will go to the factory. Now, what we are looking here is that what is our average outgoing quality through this sampling process? This is what we want to calculate here. So here we are taking the same example that we have a sample size of 80 and acceptance number is 3. If number of defectives are 0, 1, 2, 3, we accept the lot. If it's more than that, we reject the lot. When we reject the lot, that rejected lot will go through 100% screening and bad parts will be replaced by good parts. So what we want to do is, using this acceptance sampling, what will be the quality which we are receiving? That's what we want to calculate here. As a first example, let's assume that we have lots which have 2% rejection. So this is what we say. Take an example of 2% rejection. Now we made a table earlier where we found out the probability of each of these. And we said that if a lot has 2% defectives, the chance of that lot getting accepted is 0.921187 or let's say 0.92 or 92% chance. This is something which we have already covered when we created the OC curve. So 2% defective lot comes, there's a 92% chance of that lot getting accepted, 8% chance of that lot getting rejected. So let's say if we have 100 such lots, then what will happen is 92 of these lots will be accepted and 8 of these lots will get rejected. Those rejected lots will go through screening and bad parts will be replaced by good parts. Now what we want to find out, what will be the quality which we are receiving. So let's see that calculation. Because as we earlier said that if a lot has 2% defectives, there is a 92% chance of that lot getting accepted. So that means 92% of times we will get a lot which has 2% defective. So this is what will happen in our average outgoing quality. All the 92 lots will have 2% defectives in that. What about that 8% which were rejected? Now, since these 8% lots have been cleaned, fully checked, and all the bad parts replaced with the good parts, those 8% lots will be very clean. So they will have zero defective. So that's what I am doing here. 0.8 multiplied by 0. So this gives me average outgoing quality of 0.0184 or 1.8% roughly. So even though the lot which we were receiving on the average has 2% defectives, what we are receiving on the other end is 1.8% rate of defect. The average quality which we are receiving is 1.8% defectives. This is the simplified formula. And then there is a formal calculation formula which we are not talking about. So this is what we did for 2%. Same thing we do for 3%, for 4%, for 5%. Let's take the example of 5%. The probability of accepting a lot which had 5% defective was 0.433. This, if I multiply by 5%, this gives me 0.0217. So that means if I get a lot which has 5% defectives in that, the average outgoing quality will be 2.17% only. Because number of these lots, more than 50% lots will be rejected. Those lots will be cleaned and those lots will come back. So that will basically give me a good quality of 2.17%. Now, if I plot all these things, how does that look like? Let's see that on the next slide. So here I have my AOQ, average outgoing quality. What I have done is I have plotted all these numbers on the plot. You might be a little bit surprised here that when a lot has 1% defectives, then roughly what we are getting in our factory or as an average outgoing quality is 1%. When a lot has 4% defectives, we are getting around 2.4. So in case of a lot which has 9% rejection, what you are receiving is less than 1% defective as an average outgoing quality. This one is good because with 9% rejection or with the 9% defective item in the lot, more or less every lot has to go through 100% screening, replacing bad parts with the good parts. So that's the reason you're getting a good quality. So this is how you calculate AOQ or the average outgoing quality. So this leads us to another term in acceptance sampling, which is AOQL, average outgoing quality limit. What is that? Let's see that on the next video.